Hey guys, what's up? And welcome to today's video. I know you're all thinking it, the elephant in the room. She has her hair down. I took a shower last night and I kind of just put it on top of my head in a bun. And when I woke up this morning, I just had like these nice natural waves going on. And I was like, girl, yes, this is like a rare occasion. I'm going to take advantage of this. I popped out my Beach Wave 3 barrel curler thing and just add a little bit more oomph to it. And I was like, boom, ready to go. I have been getting so many headaches recently. I'm surprised that wearing my hair up so often hasn't caught up with me sooner. But I was like, girl, you gotta give it a rest. Pretty soon, I feel like my hairline is just gonna start receding and pulling back because I wear my hair up so much. So it was definitely time for a break, but I do have to say I'm digging it. I also avoided wearing my hair down for a long time because I do have, I feel like there's just hair frizzing everywhere when I wear my hair down. Anyways, I do have a lot of grays. I haven't dyed my hair since September. And on one of my videos, I don't remember which one, but somebody commented and said, respectfully, can I ask why it is that you choose to let your grays grow out? Is it on purpose? Something along those lines. And I just kind of thought to myself, okay, is it just me? Or is this kind of a rude question? Like, I don't think the person's intent was to be rude, but in my brain, I'm like, I don't think I would ever ask somebody that. Imagine going up to somebody on the street or going up to a friend or a family member, going to them like, do you just grow your gray hair out on purpose? Or do you not like to dye it? Do you leave the roots gray? It just feels weird to me. Like, I'm kind of embracing it. I just really don't give a shit. And I'm gonna be real with that. And my thing is here on my channel is I always want to be inspiring. And I don't think that anyone should feel pressure to ever dye their hair to cover up anything. And so I'm kind of like in a protest right now. I am just letting my hair go. And if anyone has a problem with my gray hair, then they're in the wrong spot. So I'm just gonna say that. I'm gonna embrace it. I'm gonna wear my hair down despite the fact that it is very gray in certain parts. You probably can't tell as much right now because yes, it is clean for once, but it is what it is. So now that we are done talking about that, the purpose of this video today is I'm going to be sharing with you my favorite eyeshadow palettes for spring. I've been waking up early in the morning these days and I hear the birds chirping. And despite everything that is going on right now, we just need to talk about something fun and dig into our creative sides. And that's kind of how I felt today when I was creating this eye look. I was like, I love pastels. And springtime is one of my all-time favorite seasons. I just love that the trees are starting to bud and there's the beginning of flowers and new life and the grass is coming back and the snow is melting. And in the Midwest, I hope for warmer temperatures. Sometimes I have to wait till May for that. But nonetheless, I absolutely love spring. So we're just going to jump right into it. I'm going to be sharing with you guys my favorite eyeshadow palettes for spring. All right, so I'm sure you guys can guess this first palette. I think I'm not the only one. When I think of a spring eyeshadow palette, I immediately think of the Sweet Talk palette from ColourPop. When they launched this last year, the second I saw this, I was like, yes, this just screams springtime, the peachy tones, the duochrome type glitters in here. It is just so soft and bright. You can just take one shadow from this palette and sweep it all over the lid and just have such a beautiful spring light floral look. I absolutely love it. One of my favorites in here is this one right here, which is Side to Side. Now this palette has made it into plenty of my favorites videos, but like, look at that. It is a Super Shock shadow. It is that formula, but it is designed to be able to withstand a palette like this. Usually the Super Shocks that come in the little tubs, you have to keep them so airtight because if air gets in there, they kind of lose their bouncy texture, the formula that makes it so beautiful. But look at that. It's just the most gorgeous topper. It is so glittery. The mattes in here are fabulous. Let's see the shade Meadow, I absolutely love, and Dreammaker. Such beautiful shades. Like, look at how these swatch. They are so pigmented, buttery smooth. Oh, beautiful. This palette just encompasses everything that is spring, from the design on the palette to the shadows on the inside. Absolutely gorgeous. So the Sweet Talk palette from ColourPop, I do know, unfortunately, that they have closed their distribution centers at this point. You can still place orders, but we don't know when anything is going to ship. So I just want to throw that out there. That may be the case for a lot of the palettes that I'm about to talk about with everything that's going on, but hey, let's still talk about them when everything goes back to normal, which it will. I'm a firm believer. Then these items will be available. Moving on to a smaller palette. This is from Persona. This is their pink palette. This is part of their color theory line. Just beautiful matte shades. If you love pink tones, things that are just a little bit more romantic, then you will absolutely love this. If you're not a fan of having a ton of shades in one palette, you just want something smaller, something easier to work with, or if you just specifically want a few pinky matte shades, then you will absolutely love this. It just has 5 colors here. They are all matte, like I stated, but they are beautiful, and my goodness, are they pigmented and blend effortlessly. I absolutely love, love, love this palette. It just looks beautiful on the eyes. And again, super pigmented, but they blend beautifully. So this is another one that I absolutely love for this time of year. I have another ColourPop palette, the Give It To Me Straight. Now this one I think launched in 2018. This is just bridal season right here. So wedding season is approaching. This palette is just beautiful for this. Now to me, this is kind of a dupe for the Kylie Cosmetics Burgundy Extended palette. I feel like these shades are very similar. They're not the exact same, but if you love that palette, but you're on a little bit more of a budget, or you just don't want to spend that much, this is an awesome option because it is very similar. One of my favorite shades in here is this champagne shade up front, the shade straight up, and then the shade candid. Now these are metallic shades, but I do want to swatch them for you just so I can show you how gorgeous they are. Look how beautiful. Absolutely stunning. This one here has like almost like a duochrome effect to it. Same with this one up here. And my goodness, for highlighting the brow bone and the inner corner. Gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful shades. Like I said, extremely romantic, just bridal type shades. Soft, perfect for spring. Absolutely love these. You can get just like a gorgeous, very wearable nude look out of this, but really encompass just like that kind of floral soft look. The next one I have to talk about here is actually a palette from Alter Ego. This is the Daydream palette. Now, this is a dupe for the, I want to say, is it the nude palette? I don't remember what the exact name is, but this is a dupe for a Huda Beauty palette. This formula does not disappoint. Now, in case you are interested, I do have a discount code with Alter Ego. It will get you 10% off of your order. I will put that on the screen somewhere here or there, and then also in the description box below. But this palette is breathtaking. I do want to swatch this one for you guys as well. I will swatch some of the matte shades as well as some of the metallic shades just to show you guys. But the formula is stunning. Like, look at that. So beautiful. They are pigmented. Absolutely gorgeous for the price. I believe this palette sits somewhere around $16. You get all of these shades. There's also 2 pressed glitters in here as well. And they did also include the concealer here as well. So if you want to create cut creases or you want to use this as your eyeshadow base, you can. But again, just another soft collection of shades, another one that is perfect for wedding season or just creating those very soft romantic looks. Daydream from Alter Ego, another beautiful palette. The next one is a palette from Juvia's Place. Now, I wore this shadow on my eyes, and I think it was in my palette declutter video that I did recently, and so many of you asked what eyeshadows I had on, and this was the palette. So I believe it's called the Douce. I hope I'm saying that right. For some reason, I just can't get this, but this is again a palette from Juvia's Place. Look how fun and gorgeous these shades are. Very playful. You have some brighter shades in here. This green shade is to die for. It is one of my all-time favorites, Macaroons, and I will swatch that one for you guys. I love this. In fact, this is one of the colors that I wear pretty much every single time I open up this palette. I absolutely love it. And then the shade Puffs is another beautiful one as well. So pretty. Look at that lavender. And those two together, that's actually what I end up pairing up on my eyes. I kind of put this in the center of the lid, and then I put this from the inner corner and then kind of dab that on the remaining part of the lid. And they are so beautiful together. I'll swatch some of the mattes for you too. So this shade right here, Custard, which is like more of like a bright purpley pink. And then we have a nice brown shade in here called Crepes. Gorgeous palette. I love, 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 love this palette. Some of my favorite looks I create using this one. So this is another really good one. And I do want to add, I just love how big the pan sizes are. I love the packaging. Such a perfect palette for spring. All right, you guys, just a couple more palettes to get through. You guys know I'm going to talk about this one. This is the Too Faced Natural Lust Palette. Now, some of you have commented on my videos before saying that you can get this palette for a ridiculous deal at TJ Maxx. And I'm telling you, if you are at a TJ Maxx or a Marshalls, a Nordstrom Rack, wherever, and you see this palette for a deal, pick it up because it is gorgeous. This is actually the palette I wore on my wedding day. But again, another soft, neutral palette that you can rock for every single day looks. It just embodies spring because it's soft. It's very wedding season. It is just absolutely gorgeous. There are so many shades to choose from. I have dipped into probably 90% of this palette, and I can promise you that they blend gorgeously. The metallics are stunning, and they do wear for a very, very long time. As I mentioned, I did wear this on my wedding day. It was well over 80 degrees, and it withstood the wedding ceremony, the dinner afterwards, hanging out afterwards in the city. It really held up. I love the packaging. And just look at this. Flowers and birds. And it just feels so pretty and romantic and feminine. And I absolutely love that palette. Last but not least, what I have on my eyes right now is the 35i. This is the Icy Fantasy from Morphe. If you want a good pastel palette that isn't going to break the bank, I cannot recommend this one enough. This is what I am wearing on my eyes today. I do have this shade right here, actually all over the lid, and then I dragged this pink shade all along the lower lash line, and then this kind of iridescent purpley icy tone I put in the inner corners and on the brow bone. It is gorgeous. Now, I do have a tip with this palette. If you really want to maximize the pigment, I suggest using more of like a flat shader brush, packing on the shade, and then kind of blending it out with a fluffier brush. That will give you the most intense color payoff with this palette. Same with kind of enhancing this lower lash line right here. A more densely packed shader brush, something that's more flat, or even like a very densely packed pencil brush, and kind of run that along the lower lash line, you're going to get the best color payoff using this palette. The metallics, I definitely suggest using your finger, but my goodness, this palette is gorgeous. And obviously for the springtime, everyone needs a good pastel palette. And this one is super fun. It's pretty much got all the pastel colors that you need. For me, this is not something that I dip into all the time. So just having one palette that's large enough that has all of these colors in it works perfectly for me. I do want to swatch for you guys the shades that I used today, just to kind of give you an idea because they are gorgeous. So let's go ahead and swatch. There's that pink matte shade. Now the green shade I have all over the lid is more of like a satin finish, which isn't usually something I would put all over my eye and like into the crease, or say all over the lid, all over my eye, but it just works and I am loving it. So this one, as you can see, is very subtle. It's more of like an iridescent. You can use it as a topper, but it works perfectly for the inner corner and the brow bone. It does pop, but absolutely gorgeous palette. So there you guys have it. Those are all of the eyeshadow palettes that just make me feel very inspired and ready for spring and just make my look feel very soft and beautiful and feminine. Sometimes it's nice to kind of go through my collection and kind of grab out palettes that really just get me in a certain mood or feeling some type of way and just lift my spirits. I do have to say that during all of this downtime that I have had a lot of time to sit and think about not only artistically looks that I could come up with, you know, in my head, but also content wise. It's a really good time to just kind of tap in to your creative self. If that's something that you're interested in, whether it's painting, practicing makeup, playing with different techniques, watching tutorials, that sort of thing, it's just a perfect time to kind of enrich the mind and expand our horizons and just tap into parts of our brain that maybe we usually don't, you know, to really think about what to be grateful for. So use the time wisely. I just want to thank you guys so much for watching. listening, if you weren't aware, there is a giveaway going on my channel. If you check out the community tab, all of the details are there. I also posted it on Twitter, so if you are following me there, I did make a post about the giveaway as well. So yeah, check out those areas for details. If you are not already, I would love it if you would consider subscribing to my channel here and hitting that bell button so that you get notifications when I upload videos just like this one. And of course, if you enjoy the content, not only subscribe, but please give this video a huge thumbs up. That definitely gives me a boost in the YouTube algorithm. It helps my content be discovered. Comment down below what palettes you are loving for spring, or if there's certain makeup that just get you in a seasonal mood. And of course, be sure to share this video if you liked it. I love you guys so, so much, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Mwah. Love you guys, stay safe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.